Hey there, it's your PowerPoint bestie. Recently, I had a lot of positive comments on some work I submitted to the Articulate eLearning Heroes Weekly Challenge. A lot of other instructional designers had questions about how I achieved certain effects with shapes and video. I'll break those down one by one in a series of short videos on this channel. The first sample I'll work through is how to create layers with cutouts. It's not usually the most eloquent option considering everything else PowerPoint has to offer, but it's a great skill because it allows you to create the illusion of video panning just by using PowerPoint animation motion paths on a static image. This video will also show a couple additional skills, like shape duplication, shape merging, and color eyedropping. The first thing I'll do is change the slide layout to blank, which removes those placeholder text boxes from the slide. Next, I'll insert a rectangle, starting all the way from the top left and stretching down to the bottom right corner so it covers the entire slide. I like to slow down at the corners so I can see it snap into alignment with the guides. I'll change this to a different color so I can better visually contrast this shape against what I'm about to do as I'm working. This color is random and only temporary. Now, I'm ready to insert an additional rectangle, and this one will be long and narrow. I'll grab the rotation handle and rotate it to about 45 degrees, just eyeballing it, based on what looks good to me. I'll then reposition it up to the corner. To duplicate this shape, I'll hold down the control key while I click and drag away from the shape. This works with most objects. I'll put this one lower on the screen, then repeat that step to add a third rectangle higher on the screen. Then I'll take a moment to reposition them in a way that looks balanced. Because these shapes have been rotated on an angle, I don't recommend using the alignment and distribution tools. But we can cover that in a different video if there's interest. Let me know in the comments. Once I have the shapes positioned to my liking, I'll select the large black rectangle, then hold down Control as I select the other three blue rectangles. Then, from the Shape Format tab, select Merge Shapes, Subtract. You can see how we've created a layer with cutouts, almost like a masquerade mask with holes for your eyes. At this point, I'll select the resulting shape and change the shape fill to white, and change the shape outline to no outline. Now, don't panic, it's still there. Even though this gives the illusion that there's nothing on this slide and that your effort so far was wasted, this is precisely what allows the PowerPoint magic to happen in our next steps. Ready to insert a picture. Since this is a demo, I'll just pick something from online pictures. For consistency with my eLearning Heroes submission, I'll find a photo of Chicago, my hometown. If you have an existing photo you'd prefer to use, that's perfectly fine too. The image already stretches from top to bottom of the page, so I don't need to resize it. However, I will send it to the back and reposition it as far over to the right as possible, without leaving a gap in the holes of the white rectangle. A tip here is to hold down the Shift key while dragging to the side so it can only move on one axis. It doesn't matter that it hangs off the slide region, that won't be visible. With the image still selected, I'll use the Animations tab to add an animation, specifically a motion path. In this case, I want the image to move to the left. I want this to happen automatically, so I'll select Start with Previous. I also want it to move slowly enough that the viewer can actually see the different buildings in the video, so I'll slow down the duration to 5 seconds. Next, I'll be adding in some quick content to the slide. First, I'll insert a heading. Careful here, if you insert a text box directly onto a shape, it incorporates the text directly into the shape, so don't let the white shape fool you the way you hope it fools others. I'll just insert the text box in the slide margin and then reposition it. I'll change the font, increase the size, and apply bold formatting. I'll then duplicate the text box to use for body text. I'll lose the bold formatting and, for demo purposes, paste in some lorem ipsum text I grabbed earlier from an online generator. I use the paste keep text only option and then resize the text box to fit the width of the space on my slide. Then I'll reduce the font size, add some line breaks, and fuss with it until it's how I like. I'll give it a lighter font to distinguish it from the heading. This is already a functional slide, but I like to tie the text and images together with one more small step. With the heading text highlighted, I'll go up to the font color tool and select eyedropper. Then I'll grab a color from the image that's bright and also will contrast nicely against the white. And that's it. To preview your work, click to view in slideshow mode. Depending on how you're using it, you might want to adjust the animation timing or image positioning, but all things considered, our slide works. If you found this video helpful, please like and subscribe, and check out additional PowerPoint tutorials on my channel.